Do you have an audiogram but don't know how to read it? Well, in this video, I'm talking about how to read a hearing test. Coming up. Hi, I'm Dr. Derek, audiologist with ProFitHearing.com, bringing you the best insight in today's latest hearing aids and audio technology to improve your life. If you have concerns about your hearing, always consult with your local physician or audiologist. On this channel, we provide hearing healthcare education and audio technology product reviews. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon to be notified whenever a new video is posted. Check out the notes in the description below for more information, and make sure to watch until the end of the video for my free ebook offer. All right, let's jump into the video. Today, I'm talking about how to read your audiogram. Understanding your audiogram is the first step to knowing if you have hearing loss, how hearing loss may impact you, and what kind of treatment you might benefit from. A hearing test is completed while wearing headphones and shows how well you hear sounds ranging from low to high pitches. The sounds start off soft and are gradually increased to determine the level where you can just barely hear the sound. This is called your threshold level, and it's recorded on the audiogram. In addition to using regular headphones for testing, there's also a headphone that rests behind your ear on the bone. It's called a bone conductor, and it measures how well you hear sounds through your skull. You will also be asked to repeat back words to see how well you understand speech in quiet with no visual cues or no lip reading. Testing will be completed in a sound-treated booth so that an accurate result can be obtained. The soft sounds or beeps that you hear during the hearing test are called pure tones. Your responses are arranged on the audiogram according to the pitch, which is measured in frequency or hertz or Hz along the top, and volume, which is measured in decibels or dB on the side. Pitch is arranged from low on the left-hand side to high on the right-hand side, just like a piano. A volume of 0 dB at the top is very soft, while 110 dB at the bottom is extremely loud, like a jet engine. The red O indicates the right ear results, and the blue X indicates the left ear results. The O and the X's are your responses to the hearing test and indicate the softest level where you hear each sound. The O's and the X's mark your hearing threshold levels for air conduction or regular headphones. You should also have a small red or blue bracket near to or above the O's and X's, which indicates how well you hear the tones with bone conduction. This audiogram indicates normal hearing thresholds in both ears at a very soft volume of 0 decibels for all the low and high pitch sounds. This audiogram shows the different degrees of hearing loss that may exist. Your hearing is within normal range if all the O's and X's are at 25 dB or less for adults. Any results that are outside the normal range is considered hearing loss that can potentially have an impact on daily communication. The severity and configuration of the hearing loss is important when deciding whether to proceed with hearing aids. Hearing aids can improve speech understanding and communication anytime your results fall outside the normal range, but make sure to consult with your audiologist or doctor of audiology to determine if a hearing aid is right for you. I'm now going to have a sample audiogram so that you can have a better understanding of how to read your own audiogram results. This audiogram indicates a hearing loss in both ears. You can see that the position of the O's and the X's are exactly the same, meaning that there's no difference in hearing between the right and left ears for all the sounds from low to high pitches. This person experiences decreased hearing sensitivity, mostly in the high pitches, which is very common. The audiogram shows that this person's thresholds for the low pitch tones are in the 30 to 40 dB range, while their thresholds in the high pitch tones are mostly in the 55 to 70 dB range. Hearing loss with this configuration is often caused by loud noise exposure and gradual hearing loss associated with aging. All of the sounds below the blue and red lines are audible to this person, while all the sounds that are above the blue and red lines are not audible. Without hearing aids, this person will not hear a large percentage of sounds that an otherwise normal hearing listener would experience. Hearing aids adjusted to this audiogram would amplify the high-pitched sounds more than the low-pitched sounds so that this person could have improved speech understanding and clarity of words. Hearing loss in the high-pitched tones can significantly impact the ability to understand words, especially in background noise. High-pitched sounds correspond to the consonants in speech, and these sounds provide the fine detail and understanding of words. Hearing loss in the high-pitch range makes it difficult to understand what people are saying. The other person may be speaking loud enough, but their words just aren't clear. Understanding speech is especially difficult for hearing-impaired people when they're seated at a far distance away from the speaker, in the presence of background noise, and when the speaker's mouth cannot be visualized while speaking. So if you have hearing loss and want to improve your ability to understand what's being said, make sure you minimize distance, reduce background noise, and face the person speaking for better visual cues. In addition to measuring the soft tones that we hear, word recognition ability is also recorded on the audiogram. Words are presented at a comfortable volume and quiet to determine whether you have any difficulty understanding words. If you have hearing loss, word recognition scores are also an estimate of how well you will understand words while wearing hearing aids in a quiet environment. If you have good word recognition scores, you should adapt well to hearing aids. People with more severe hearing loss may have poor word recognition even when listening to words at a loud volume. In these cases, a hearing aid may not make words clear enough to understand, so cochlear implant surgery may be considered by an ear, nose, and throat doctor. Your audiologist and ENT doctor can conduct a cochlear implant evaluation to determine if you are a candidate. In addition to soft sound and word testing, a few other screening tests may appear on the audiogram. These include tympanograms, acoustic reflexes, and otoacoustic emissions, or OAEs. A tympanogram applies some pressure inside the ear canal to see if there's normal eardrum movement. Abnormal eardrum movement may indicate an ear infection, middle ear fluid, or something abnormal with the ear bone function. Acoustic reflexes are a measure of how the eardrum moves in response to loud sounds. Normally, an acoustic reflex should be present in both ears. An absence of acoustic reflexes may be caused by various types of hearing loss or other medical issues. Otoacoustic emissions, or OAEs, are recorded from the ear's outer hair cells in response to soft tones. Hair cells are located inside the inner ear and are responsible for transmission of auditory signals up to the brain. This test does not require any response from the patient, and it results in a pass or fail. A fail result is expected if the patient has hearing loss and/or abnormal middle ear function. This test is especially helpful to estimate a patient's hearing sensitivity when they cannot reliably respond to other behavioral testing. So for today's question, do you feel more comfortable reading your own audiogram? Was this video helpful? I'd love to know your thoughts, so please comment below. What other videos do you want to see? Let's connect in the comments. Make sure to check out my other videos where I'll discuss the different types of hearing loss that can be identified on an audiogram. These include conductive, sensory neural, and mixed hearing loss. I'll leave a link in the suggested videos above or at the end of this video once those are available. Your audiologist can advise you on specific treatment options for your hearing loss. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you receive value from this video, please like it, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to be notified whenever a new video is posted. Remember to check out the notes in the description below for more information and to connect with ProFit Hearing on social media. Be a part of the ProFit Hearing community. If you're interested in hearing aids, click on the link in the description below for my free ebook, How to Buy Hearing Aids. Know what to ask your audiologist or hearing aid dispenser so that your hearing aids are easy to use and have all the features you're looking for. Remember, ProFit Hearing brings you the best insight in today's latest hearing aids and audio technology to improve your life. If you have concerns about your hearing, always consult with your local physician or audiologist. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.